The floods are going to wipe value from a lot of dream homes and rob a lot of nest eggs.
The army, the teams of volunteers are edging closer, deeper into the affected suburbs. What never changes is the pain at every turn.
It's bloody good to have a cry sometimes. And just emotion, mate, just emotion.
For Graceville resident Paul Nielsen, the kindness of the volunteers is the only thing spurring him on. His neighbours also lost everything.
250,000 gone, just disappeared, I guess.
More than a metre of water ran through Fairfield Gardens shopping centre's 30 stores. The stock losses are astronomical.
We're talking in the millions, definitely. And I really couldn't give you an indication because each day that we come here, there's more and more that we discover.
The centre could be closed for 10 weeks, but elsewhere people are bouncing back.
I'm opening and I want to trade, and I figure I have to trade my way out of this mess.
Murray Dalton's Milton fish shop has been shut down for a week. He lost all his stock.
It was a double blow for Murray Dalton. His 100-year-old family home was also flooded. Like so many others, his insurance claim has been knocked back.
Others are still trying to salvage their treasures.
We've been told by the owners that they're valuable and they're worth trying to save.
Private art collections worth more than $250,000 went under. These 120 mud-stained paintings are by renowned artists like Arthur Boyd.
Hopefully we can get rid of most of the mud and it'll become art again.
Many of the victims just as optimistic.
We'll get over it, buddy.
Good on you.
We'll get over it.
Nicholas Boot, 10 News.